finally got round to it. I'm going to review these, the M&M chocolate bars. And the hazelnut one is 165 gram. The crispy one is 150 gram. 165 gram for the normal chocolate one and 165 for the peanut one. I'm going to start with just the normal chocolate one. And do you know what? I think they've missed out a trick here. I think they should have had a fruit and nut one. Yeah. Gone into competition with Cadbury or something. They were priced at £2 on a special offer price. And they've generally been about that price everywhere I've seen them, or more. Maybe up to £2.50. And I think the reason why they've done that is so that they don't get ditched off into Poundland or other pound shops. I think it's to try and keep the perception of it's a bit better than your mass market sort of stuff. Let's have a look inside, if I can get it open. It's meant to be resealable, but good grief. I tried to open it nicely and I end up still breaking it. What does it look like? Oh, that's cute! That's cute, it's got a picture of him on it as well, look. Oh, that's good. There's a few M&Ms poking through the chocolate. That's good. I'm going to slide that back in because I'm not going to be a pig and eat all this. Look, some little M&Ms there, look. Now, I'm used to tasting Cadbury chocolate on its own and Nestle chocolates on its own. But M&M, not so much. I mean, Mars, not so much. No. It's somewhere between Nestle and Galaxy. With a bit of a cheapness taste to it, obviously, because it is a generic chocolate mix from M&M, Mars. Not bad. Not bad. But you know what? I think I would struggle to get through that whole pack. 165 gram is quite a weighty sort of chocolate bar. Now on the back of all these, they've only used the yellow dude. I'm not up with the names of the characters of the M&Ms. Do they have names? Are they just called yellow and red and orange and brown or whatever? I don't know. The next one I'm going to try is the peanut one. I think peanut M&Ms are obviously the most famous flavour, aren't they? Peanut M&Ms, when you go to the pictures or Christmas time, if it isn't M&Ms, you're eating, obviously, it's probably Maltesers. Peanut M&Ms are the best. Is it the same display? It's the same bloke. Oh, this one's broken. But it's the same one on there. Red. I think they are just called red, yellow and whatnot, aren't they? Well, they're not called whatnot, but... Right, so this is the yellow one. So this one should have nuts in it as well. I can see that they've got some nuts in there. Not as many as what I think there should be, though. I think each block should at least have a peanut in it. I don't think there's enough nuts in this. I'm getting a nutty taste, but... It's nice. It is nice. But... That is actually really good. I think the peanuts help break the chocolate down a lot better. You know, like how peanut butter dissolves chewing gum. I think it must have the same effect on chocolate. It just That was covering my tongue much better. The peanut one's very good. I would have preferred more crunch though. I would have liked a few more nuts in there to crunch on. But very good. I like that. I hope to keep that in production. The next one I'm going to try is the hazelnut one. I'm not so sure what I'm expecting with this one at all, because I wanted that one a bit nuttier, didn't I? So, will I want this one to be a bit more hazelnuttier? We'll have to find out, won't we? In moments when I get into this packaging. Do you like M&Ms? Let me know in the comment section. I'm below Scratch. Let me know. Been to M&M World? Have been to M&M World. It's great. The big silos of every colour M&M you can think of. Absolutely amazing. If I won the lottery, I think I'd just stick my head under one of the silos. It's like, why not? It looks like they've gone for a shard effect on this one. It's the same design as well, I think. Is it the same design? Yeah, they've just used the same chocolate mould to make the chocolate bars. It'd have been... I love that design. It's really good. However, breaking pieces off like this is impossible. All the way through. Instantly getting hazelnut flavour. That is good. You know what? It's reminded me a lot of the chocolate almond and nut bar, or whatever it is, you can get from Aldi. That is really nice. That is good. These two are amazing. Oh, I should have warned you, shouldn't I? If you're allergic to nuts, don't watch this video, but, no, well, it's too late now, isn't it? Both the nutty ones, absolutely brilliant. The original one, not so much. I'm not too bothered if they discontinue the original one, but keep the peanut one and the hazelnut one. And the crispy one, I don't see what could possibly do wrong here. Because it's just going to be a bit like Rice Krispies sort of thing, isn't it? Mixed with chocolate and Skittles. Oh, Skittles. M&Ms. I like Skittles as well. I don't like Mars things quite a lot. I don't think there's very much of Mars I don't like, actually. Because I do like Bounty. Dark chocolate Bounty. Yeah, because Mars don't really make as much variety. But yet they still make a lot of stuff that's really good. That I like. M&Ms, Maltesers, Bounty, Skittles. I mean, I know that's in their subsidiary for sweets, which is Wrigley's. Yeah, same design again. So they've just used the same chocolate mould. Let's try a crispy one. Looks as if it's going to be very crispy. This is obviously going to be one of the cheapest versions to make, isn't it? Because they can just shove loads of the crispy bits in it. I should say obviously as well, but this is not a paid for promotion by Mars or anybody like that. This is just me and my money and my mouth and my chocolate that I've bought. Crispy already. This one has a much better texture than the first. That one's alright. The crispy one is alright. They should have definitely made a fruit and nut one. Absolutely. But Mars don't really do any fruit and nut flavoured things, do they? So I don't think they'd be able to do it because they'd have to bring in and brand new products that they don't normally work with. But third place, first place, a very close second place, fourth place. All of them are definitely worth the money. There's a lot of chocolate there. I've only had one row of each and I'm feeling quite chocolate-fied already. And I've definitely had enough, which is good because that means that I'm very unlikely to finish at all. If this was a Cadbury one, which is full, I dare say that's got more sugar in a Cadbury Dairy Milk, I'd probably just like nicked it all by now. But the texture of all of them except the first one, the brown one, was really, really good. And I would recommend them all. Maybe not so much this one. Maybe not so much this one. Unless you want a less sweet one and one with less busyness going on. The other three are very good. Particularly the nutty ones. Good flavour and good taste. Absolutely. Anyway, thanks for watching. Please grasp, bell me. Let me know in the comment section down below if you've bought these. Or if you're thinking of buying them, and if you agree or disagree, and if you've been to M&M World, and yeah, thanks for watching. Scrass Bellamy, bye.